something before you go away and answer 112 different questions without knowing what the purpose of those questions are. So I'm going to ask you again, Daniel.
Why do you hate me?
What questions need to be answered?
We don't know.
That's what I'm saying to you. You need to read through.
We did read through.
You are not in fourth grade where you're just looking at a bunch of questions saying, oh, go to an encyclopedia and find the answers to those. Those questions
What's
have a purpose. Figure out what the purpose is before you just randomly go off and spend an awful lot of time looking up all those randomly individual questions.
Oh, Schneider. We hate.
It says that you have to address all
of the assignments. At some point in your life,
assignments.
You look forward to being challenged.
All of the assignments.
Yeah, but I'm doing something I like called farming. This is not farming. This is hurting my brain.
But John just took a second job.
Yeah.
As an electrician.
Yeah, Daniel.
0 minutes of training as an electrician.
What?
What?
You
spelled
works wrong.
You worked
4 days on.
No, I didn't.
Okay. So number 10 is just a roof, right? We need to write an essay.
Basically a troubleshooter. That's not the name thing.
On this essay, Rubric says... assigned questions, but we don't know what
the assigned
questions. So we need to go to 8.
Correct.
If not, 3.
So you know the opinion of all the kinds of people involved in GMO issues, but how do you feel? What's your opinion? Do you think GMOs are good and bad?
Isn't that what Mary just said?
Okay. Hi, Daniel. Are you going to yell at me?
Yes! Okay, so our final goal is a rubric.
The final goal is a rubric.
Or not a rubric.
An
essay.
Right.
And are these the questions we're trying to answer at the very top there when we get this whole project done?
Some of them, yes. There's also others.
We just cleared.
But here's the deal with that. You guys are looking at those sets of questions as simply looking at those for facts. You always need to keep in mind all of the questions that need to be answered when you are looking for the answers to those really simple, basic questions. Parker, what color is your pen? Okay, ready? Now, here's the deal. I asked him a very simple black and white question, right? Very simply answered, right? Now I want you to wonder, why did I ask that? What's my big goal?
Know what the color is?
Okay.
To start us thinking.
Correct. You always need to keep in mind the position that you are trying to solve, what you're trying to debate when you're answering those really simple questions. Okay? So when I ask you what questions need to be answered, you have a lot of them in there, right? Yes, you always have to keep those in mind. Right? Okay, Jamin. Did you read this one? Awesome.
So we need to answer, get to the point where we can, which 8 says we need to get to the point where we can, we know all, what kind of people are involved in GMO issues. We need to know how we feel about it, and we need to know what our opinion is and whether it is good or bad. We also need to know what's under here.
Yeah, you're just thinking about it.
Now he's on the right track.
And we also need to know what, who genetically modified organisms are, what they are, where they are, when they are, why they're here, and how they're here.
Okay.
Okay.
So yeah.
You're going to
use your
mouth. No, that's not quite true. Remember? It's not, but here's the deal. Don't think about them in isolation, Parker. Daniel, don't think about them in isolation, right? If you think about them in isolation, then you're simply looking at them for one goal.
So we should answer them all. so that way we can have an understanding of how.
But when you are gaining that understanding of those lists of questions, think about your final goal the whole time.
Okay.
Why do I need to know this? How does this fit with that final goal?
It's wondering how they are. Our final goal is to know why, how they're modified genetically.
Correct.
So our goal, when we're researching them, we should research like how they can be modified.
Correct. What does GMO
how are,
do to photosynthesis
so
in a plant?
So each of them separate parts, we should search how has genetically modified.
So for like each question,
change this.
Correct.
Part of the plant.
Correct. Now you're thinking about it as a whole, not as just an isolation.
So we're still answering every one of them questions, except we're going to research. How is it genetically modified?
Then you click on the yellow. And I want you to click on those things. I want you to highlight those questions that you think you know the answers to. Do you think you know what that means? That's what I want you to do. I want you to read these, and I want you to figure out those questions that you know the answers to. Okay? Yes. That's what I want you to read them. Highlight those questions.
We need to
questions.
Figure out what are
just like this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you think you know the answer to? Do you know what a leaf is? I want you to highlight that one. What are you? Because I think you know the answer. And I want you to highlight any questions you think you know the answer to.
But
right now, do that right now. And save it.
You want
to hit save it.
We still
have
to answer all the questions.
So we'll answer all the questions, but we'll try to get to
it.
Come back together real quick. What have you guys as a group figured out now?
That I can balance this highlighter on this one.
No, not you. Because I know they've got it, so I'm going to have them share out their information.
Nope. I'm going to.
But they've spent our work.
Daniel,
that's
why it's a collaborative effort.
Daniel, we've all spent our work on this. Okay, so what y'all gotta do, in document 4, you gotta answer all of the questions asking, like, how, or, like, why, or how, or when, or where, or whatever, how genetically modified, or genetic engineering has changed each of the questions. And each of like the parts and of the plant and stuff.
What I'm hearing an awful lot of is a very, very typical response when you see a set of questions. You think those questions exist as a silo. I'll be right with you, Jamin, okay? You think those questions exist in a silo format. I'm going to help these guys real quick first, okay? Now, the problem with that is you need to know why those questions are being asked to begin with. Right? The questions, the purpose to knowing those answers have an ultimate goal. That ultimate goal is your debate. So when you go off and you look for, man, I don't even know what one of the questions are. Bring up one of those questions on that other page. There you go. When you go find off what can bacterial genes do to plants, you can answer that. It's a black and white question. You can go to Google. You can type that in. You can copy and paste. Life is awesome. Mrs. Schneider, this is really easy. I don't care if you know the answer to that and it's written down on a sheet of paper. I care that you know it and can apply it to genetically modified plants. So you must always keep in mind those questions that are on 7, 8, 9, etc., etc. What is the ultimate goal in using that information?
How did those questions apply to the issue of GMOs? So it's not a matter of I found it, I copied it, I pasted it, ta-da, I'm done. It's a matter of understanding it and using it.
Everybody got that?
I think I understand what you mean.
Correct. Because just finding information in a silo is nothing to us. If I'm going to take my car down to Volts because it's not working right, he's going to ask me a million questions to try to put it into a context. When did it happen? What kind of a noise is occurring? Does it only happen this time of day? Did it happen when Slim drove it or when I drove it? He's going to ask a million questions to take that very simple, it's making a clinking sound.
That's a very black and white answer. He needs to put that into context of why he needs to know that. Don't look at me, our car's not making a clinking sound. It only happens when he drives it.
Mr. Schneider broke it.
He does. So, does everybody understand that? Because I hear all of you going off and separating all of these questions, which is a fine thing to do. You probably don't know all those answers, right? But always keep in mind, you need to know the answers as they apply to the end result.
Requirements for the beginning of class next time.
We're probably going to disagree with this. I've given you a deadline of the 30th for the debate. Everything needs to be done before that time period.
14 days.
That's not bad.
That isn't bad.
How many class periods is that?
But
that's fair.
Here's
six.
Yeah, and she is. Here's the deal. Erica just said that's going to go like this. There are certain things that need to be accomplished that cannot be accomplished the morning before this class period of the debate.
Oh.
So your plan of attack should include, I'm going to have my essays done here. I'm going to have this done here. I'm going to have this done here. Your plan of attack should be in Edmodo by the end of the day today.
So we should re-upload that debate.
Yeah, well, we need
and you have about 7 minutes class.
All right. Now, I can give you a little bit of time during English today because I'm going to give you, we're going to share all those resources out. You're going to have an annotated bibliography, but you guys are going to have some of your research already done. Right? We are. Just chill. I've got lots of stuff going on.
I'm so confused.
I know you're not. So, we'll get all of it done. I'm not worried about it a bit, right? But your plans of attack should be in there.
By tonight.
By the end of today.
Do you want?
Before 3:35.
Correct, Daniel.
When do we want to have our research for...
Okay. Now, class time. Don't count on class time being used to work on this. Because I'm kind of thinking that Mrs. Kellard is maybe going to throw in the math in there, like, you know, and I'm not a math person, but like, what percentage of all crops are grown genetically modified?
I don't know. Stop giving her ideas.
200,800.
She's a very creative individual. Oh. I know she's going to come up with some great math things for this.
And how many bushels is that percentage? And how many people would that feed? And what's the transportation cost? Because the food doesn't grow where the people are.
Daniel, answers.
And how come we don't have a bushel in a pack anymore? How come we don't do
oh,
that?
Yeah.
A bushel in a pack.
And a hug around
the neck.
Yeah. My mom says that.
You should type that into Bing right now. A bushel and a peck and a hug around the neck.
I'll be honest with you, my dad says that to my mom all the time.
Can I watch that one?
A bushel and a peck and a hug around the neck.
Yes.
All right? So, you know your goals here. We've given you 2 weeks and a lot of freedom.
What the hell?
What are you watching?
A bushel and a peck.
Oh my gosh, what is this?
It's a Doris Day song from a movie.
And if you know me, you know me and Doris Day. We love each other.
And if you know me, I'm in the other room watching football.
Yeah, buddy. Or baseball.
No, I won't watch baseball. They went on strike twice while I was in junior high and high school. I haven't watched a game since. They went on strike twice while I was in junior high and high school. No, it's two strikes and you're out in my world.
Just the ones that you know the answer.
They were already making more than $1 million a year playing baseball, and they got a hangnail, so they're out for 2 weeks. And you want more than $2 million a year to do that?
You don't know
what no.
So we're not gonna
I'm not watching. 4 minutes of class left and you have to have that plan of action done.
Plan of action.
Yeah, I did that.
What
we're
gonna do is our plan of action.
Okay.
So